Hi everyone, welcome to Difference Frames the World, a permanently demonetized but independent channel to see the world from a different angle. The platform demonetized our channel on the last day of 2021, saying our videos do not provide value to viewers, and we have not yet received pending payments back from Google for over 8 months. We do not dissuade viewers from watching commercials on our videos, although Google does not share a penny of the revenue with us. Some advertisements, 1 out of 1,000 probably, are more entertaining and educational than our content, according to the platform's definition. Today, we want to discuss the CHIPS and Science Act of 2022, which President Joe Biden signed into law on August 9, 2022, at local time. The bill provides enormous subsidies to chip manufacturing companies in the United States while requiring them not to develop high-end chip manufacturing in China. It is an updated version of Donald Trump's tech war against China. Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesman Wang Wenbin denounced the bill as another example of U.S. economic coercion. Washington's hawks on China are using the bill to carry out precision strikes against China's chip industry. Still, very few international mainstream media predict that the United States will be able to win the chip war. The U.S. has been getting lost in the past decades, and it has less and less influence over the chip industry. Over 30 years ago, the United States produced 40% of chips worldwide, but the U.S. has let chip manufacturing go overseas. The U.S. wants to use this law to bring chip manufacturing back to the United States. Is it a joke or a dream? Biden blamed China as usual when signing the bill into law, saying it's no surprise that China's Communist Party is actively lobbying U.S. companies against the CHIPS and Science Act. He asserted that the United States must lead the world in chip production. It is worth mentioning that the U.S. only manufactures 10% of the world's semiconductors. We said in many videos that the Republicans and Democrats would approve of anything against China, which is rare in America's divided political environment. The New York Times commented that the Republican Party, which has consistently opposed a high degree of government intervention in business, is now supporting the Democratic Party bill. In addition to supporting the U.S. domestic chip industry, it goes one step further to contain China's chip industry. Wall Street Journal mentions that the bill is more than 1,000 pages long. The most critical element of the bill is the allocation of nearly $53 billion for domestic manufacturing of chips, of which $39 billion for incentive programs and $11 billion for research and workforce development programs. In addition, the government will provide a 25% investment tax credit for U.S. domestic chip factories at an estimated cost of $24 billion. Al Jazeera discloses that the bill also includes important restrictions that those companies applying for federal subsidies must promise not to develop precision chip manufacturing in China mainland. The bill prohibits companies that receive subsidies from significantly increasing their production of advanced process chips, generally considered below 28 nanometers, in China for 10 years. Companies that violate the ban could be required to return the entire subsidy. A prominent chipmaker, Micron, announced on August 9, 2022, that it would seek to receive the federal subsidy, planning to invest $40 billion by 2030 to build new chip manufacturing plants in the United States, aiming to increase the U.S. share of the global memory chip manufacturing industry from the current 2% to 10%. Another chip giant, Intel Corporation, also said it would apply for subsidies to support its plan to build 2 chip factories in Ohio. The company will also seek subsidies for its chip plant expansion plans in Arizona and a chip packaging plant in New Mexico. TSMC, the world's largest chip maker, also said it would seek subsidies for its chip plant construction in Phoenix. The CHIPS and Science Act gives the United States more leverage for international cooperation and negotiations. The United States will probably accelerate the construction of the so-called Chip Quadrilateral Alliance to use industrial subsidies and market access as leverage to bring in South Korea, Japan, and China's renegade province, Taiwan. However, the bill's exclusionary policies for China's chip industry make many chip companies face the problem of choosing sides between the United States and China. China mainland is the world's largest chip market, so TSMC, Samsung, Intel, and other companies are in a dilemma. They all have plants on China's mainland, and TSMC even has a plant in China producing 16-nanometer chips. Over time, All U.S. equipment manufacturers have received letters from the U.S. Department of Commerce informing them not to supply equipment to China for chip manufacturing at 14 nanometers or below. According to the Financial Times, on August 10, 2022, security officials in Taiwan are forcing Foxconn, the world's largest SMT contractor, to abandon its $800 million investment in China mainland, which Foxconn announced last month. In the short run, the Chips and Science Act will adversely affect China's chip industry. The Chinese embassy in the United States expressed resolute opposition to the bill on the same day it was signed into law, denouncing it as a Cold War and zero-sum game mentality. China Council for the Promotion of International Trade and China International Chamber of Commerce have also expressed their opposition, arguing that the provisions of the bill discriminate against some foreign enterprises, highlighting the U.S. intention to use government power to forcefully change the international division of labor in the chip industry, damaging the interests of enterprises around the world, including Chinese and U.S. enterprises. The New York Times regards the bill as the ultimate arms race of the 21st century, saying its commercial and geopolitical motives push China to build chips as fast as possible. The news agency further mentions that shortly before the U.S. bill took effect, Chinese chipmakers had just made a major technological breakthrough, announcing the successful manufacture of 7-nanometer chips, which took the world by surprise. The bill may force China in chip manufacturing to carry out a greater degree of independent innovation to catch up with the United States and its East Asian partners. Some Republican lawmakers disagree with the bill and say it may just give more benefits to already highly profitable chip giants. Democrats want to say this is a competitive bill, but it's copying the Chinese playbook, Beijing's Made in China 2025. Republican Representative Rogers said the Chinese government proposed the Made in China 2025 action plan back in 2015 to invest in or subsidize 10 high-tech industries that China sees as having long-term strategic value. The Biden administration is now trying to spend more than China. China has already invested $150 billion in the chip industry, and the European Union is also legislating its chip manufacturing. As a result, the Chip and Science Act may not bring about sweeping changes. The Boston Consulting Group estimates that if Washington adopts a hard decoupling of technology from China, it may even harm some U.S. chip companies or cause them to lose 18% of global market share and 37% of revenue, and 15,000 to 40,000 highly skilled jobs. Money-wise, the Chip and Science Act subsidies will likely not cover the cost of chip companies moving factories from China to the United States. The best scenario would be those high-tech companies will apply for subsidies from the U.S. government to expand their plants in the United States, but they will keep their facilities in China. Also, those companies have plenty of measures to circumvent the bill. They can slow down the construction process in the United States, so they do not have to incur exceptionally high operational costs when enjoying the massive incentives from the government. At the same time, they can find proxies to increase investments in China, making more money out of the world's biggest market. TSMC founder Morris Chang said the cost of producing the same chip in the United States is about 50% higher than in Taiwan, and the U.S. efforts to increase local chip manufacturing are futile, wasteful, and very expensive. It is noteworthy that TSMC America will like operation in 2024 as planned, but the etching machines are seemingly from China's Shanghai. It means chip manufacturing in China mainland is quickly catching up, and no country in the world can dominate the semiconductor industry now. The Chips and Science bill enables the U.S. to support its domestic manufacturing base. Still, the U.S. can't decouple from the global supply chain, especially the chip design, manufacturing, and raw materials are distributed in many different countries and regions. The chip industry is a vast network globally, and no matter how hard the United States of America tries to localize manufacturing, a certain degree of interdependence is inevitable. China has the world's most potent manufacturing capacity and most extensive supply chain, and it is also the biggest market for chip manufacturers worldwide. It is too simple and naive for U.S. lawmakers to figure out a 1,000-page bill to curb China's chip industry. The Wolf Amendment in 2011 stopped NASA from participating in Chinese space programs, and now China is the only country that owns a space station, and more Chinese satellites are twinkling in the sky. We said the U.S. should not force China to fry chips in many videos, but the US government still believes it can strangulate China's chip industry. Before ending today's video, we want to inform viewers that our videos are available on Locals, Rumble, TikTok, Patreon, and Telegram. Although we are permanently demonetized on this platform and are not entitled to any revenue generated from advertisements on our videos, we will not give up the channel, and no one can silence our voices. Even if we face dire financial difficulties, we will not compromise on the video quality. Please help us through PayPal and Patreon, or scan the QR codes to support us on WeChat, Buy Me a Coffee, or GoFundMe.